Several years ago, a group of people, the international, wanted to start a school. And out of that, after considerable investigation and thinking the matter over, we found it must be in England. Not in France, Switzerland and Holland, but here. And this place was found for this school. And it's not a community in the sense of people living together or brought together for an idea or a principle or living, sharing their property and so on, all that kind of thing. It is not a community, but it is essentially a school which will be gradually built up to about 40 students. I hope somebody who is responsible for the school is listening and correcting me if I'm wrong. There'll be about 40 students, both boys and girls, international, and the right kind of teachers. And every year there'll be a meeting like this, either in the spring or late summer, under this tent or whatever it's called. And there'll also be small gatherings, which will not be in the tent, will be in the big room in the house. It will hold about 300, where we can discuss more directly, more intimately, more informally. And I hope this is informal here this morning. What the education is going to be is quite a different matter. That's going to be quite a problem, because the students will be from the age of 15 on up till they go to university, or they may not go to university or do something else entirely different. But that's the idea, from 15 on. We have been discussing about it. What is the point of education at all? Is merely to cultivate the capacity of memory, passing the examinations and getting a job and all the rest of that business, mechanical, rather shallow, empty, or is education something entirely different, plus the technological knowledge? Not necessarily passing exams, but be prepared to pass exams. Again, subject to correction from the authorities here. I've got an approval of what is being said. Of course, in the school, the ordinary curriculum, mathematics, geography, history, language, and science, and physics, and all that will be taught. But something more. The more is the problem. Unless we feel that we understand the whole significance of living and the meaning of life totally, not merely passing exams, getting a job and getting a married family and fitting into society or not fitting into society and all that, but what is the meaning of all this? Meaning of existence, meaning of living. Without really understanding that fundamentally, deeply, education has very little meaning. What the present society offers as education is a form of violence. Is that all right? Where the passing of examinations, competition, ambitious drive, and all that, this comparing one student against another and destroying the thing that you have compared with, is a form of competitive, ruthless, destructive way of living. And what we want to do here is to find out how to live in the world, not apart from it, but yet be non-competitive, but have the drive, the energy, the intensity without the ambition. And that demands a great deal of intelligence on our part, on the part of the teachers, the staff. And whether we can manage this depends on us. The responsibility is ours. And the school is going to begin on the 20th or 22nd of this month. Is that right? And we want eventually, there are two schools in India with which I am fortunately or unfortunately connected. This school here and those two schools will be amalgamated, joined or merged or whatever the word is. Interchange of teachers, students, and so on. So it is not just a community in the ordinary accepted sense of that word, but a school in which, if this thing can be taught to the student or brought up, create an atmosphere in which this sense of non-dual existence can be cultivated. And that's what we intend, and we are going to do it. It isn't just an idea floating in the air and we're trying to succeed or not succeed. We want to do it and we shall do it. And that's that, right?